Good morning everyone and welcome back. This is class 6th, subject social science, chapter number 8 of civics. So the new chapter we are going to start today, that is the chapter number 8 of civics, and the name of chapter is rural livelihood. Rural, that is related to the villages, and livelihood, the livings or the income that the people living in the villages they earn. So here we will learn about the ways how the rural areas people they get their livelihood, means in what type of works are they involved, that we will be covering. So it's going to be our lecture number 1. Now the topics that we'll discuss today are, number 1, introduction of the chapter we will take. Then we'll take here economic activities, because before doing the different type of work, we must know the main economic activities which are divided there in India. Okay, so here we'll discuss about the economic activities. Then number 3, story of Kalpattu village here. So we'll take the example of Kalpattu village there in Tamil Nadu, and the people of Kalpattu village, what type of work they do, types of farmers in Kalpattu, different types of farmers they are given there. So we'll take example of those farmers. Then at last we will be taking homework. So let's start with the topics. Introduction. Rural means related to the villages that I told you. We shall discuss about different ways in which people earn their living in villages. As we have already discussed about diversity in the first chapter, living in different region has an effect on the work that people do. The most important occupation in the villages is agriculture. Most of the people in villages are farmers. People in villages are engaged in non-farm activities also, such as rearing animals, making pots, utensils and baskets. So here, as we, you know that in chapter number 1 of our book, we already discussed about diversity. Diversity in which we talked about that people of different kind, or the diversity it exists there on the basis of work, on the basis of look, religion, clothes, food. So here we are talking about diversity there in the work, that people do different types of work. And if we talk about the rural area, basically they are, most of the people they are involved in agriculture. Agriculture, that is the predominant work there in the rural area. Along with it, some non-farm activities are also performed there. They can be the making of basket, pots, rearing animals. Along with it, different shops can be there, different services can also be found there. So this is all about the work that people in rural area they do. Now as we have discussed that in this chapter, we will be learning about the same, how the people in the villages they earn their livings. So the next, economic activity. There are three main economic activities. Basically there were three main activities, but nowadays one more is included. The we'll discuss all four. Number 1, primary activities. Primary activities are the activities in which the things those produce the raw material they are included. Like we can take example of agriculture. We know that agriculture in which the farmers they grow different type of crops there, and different type of crops they are used for making different material. We can take example of wheat they grow there. Okay, that is production for them. But that wheat is used for making bread, for making chapatis, ओके, फॉर मेकिंग बिस्किट्स ऑल्सो. सो दैट एक्टिविटी, दैट एग्रीकल्चर दैट इज प्रोड्यूसिंग द रॉ मटेरियल फॉर अदर थिंग्स. सो दिस इज द प्राइमरी एक्टिविटी. अलॉन्ग विद दिस प्राइमरी एक्टिविटी, दिस एग्रीकल्चर, डिफरेंट अदर एक्टिविटीज लाइक रियरिंग एनिमल, फॉरेस्ट्री, फिशिंग, ऑल दीज इन एक्टिविटीज, दे आर द प्राइमरी एक्टिविटीज बिकॉज दे आर प्रोड्यूसिंग द रॉ मटेरियल फॉर अदर थिंग्स. ओके, सेकेंडरी एक्टिविटीज दे इंक्लूड बेसिकली मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. मैन्युफैक्चरिंग फ्रॉम वेयर द रॉ मटेरियल इज यूज टू मेक द फिनिश्ड गुड और टू मेक द गुड्स दोज आर प्रिपेयर्ड दर इन द कंपनीज और द फैक्ट्रीज. सो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग वर्क दैट कम्स दे आर इन द सेकेंडरी एक्टिविटी. थर्ड इज टर्शरी एक्टिविटी, एंड इन दिस टर्शरी एक्टिविटी द सर्विसेज आर इंक्लूडेड. सर्विसेज द पीपल दोज डू द डिफरेंट वर्क, लाइक वी कैन टेक एग्जाम्पल ऑफ टीचर, डॉक्टर, इंजीनियर. सो ऑल दीज एक्टिविटीज दे कम दे आर इन द टर्शरी एक्टिविटी. सो दीज थ्री एक्चुअली वी वर लर्निंग अर्लियर, बट नाउ वन मोर इज इंट्रोड्यूस देयर, दैट इज क्वार्टरनरी एक्टिविटी. क्वार्टरनरी एक्टिविटीज बेसिकली इंक्लूड्स द सॉफ्टवेयर दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द कंप्यूटर साइंस बेसिकली, इन विच सॉफ्टवेयर द न्यू टेक्नोलॉजीज दे आर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. सो दीज आर द फोर इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज दैट आर डिवाइडेड. क्लियर? नाउ विल डिस्कस हेयर अबाउट द विलेज एरिया. And the village area, as we talked about, most of the people, they are dependent on farming or the agriculture. It means they are dependent on the primary activities. Okay, so let's discuss about that. Story of Kalpattu village. Kalpattu is a village in Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, there in South India, Kalpattu is a village. So here this Kalpattu has been taken to describe about the people living there in village and what type of activities the people they do there in this village. People of Kalpattu do farm and non-farm activities such as making baskets, utensils, pots, brakes, bullock carts, etc. So these, the making of these different things they are doing, even they, and most of the people, they are dependent on agriculture. And here when you will read the chapter in story, there are some shops are also given there, that different shops were also there in Kalpattu, where the different people, grocery shop, barber shop, clothes shop, okay. So these things, they are also found there in Kalpattu village. Then people of Kalpattu, here R will not come, people of Kalpattu also provide some services like nurses, washermen, weaver, barber, etc. Clear? Next is crops grown here in Kalpattu are paddy, coconut, cotton, sugarcane. Here if you talk about the people, those are dependent on agriculture or they are growing the crops. So, which main crops they are grown basically there? They are paddy. Paddy means that is rice. The crop of rice, coconut, cotton, and cotton fiber it is grown, sugarcane. Clear? Along with it, different even the fruits they are described there, like plantain. Plantain that is banana tree you can say, and mango. So different fruits also the people they are growing there in Kalpattu village. This is all about the work the people there in Kalpattu they do. Now the next thing that is farmers in Kalpattu village. Here in this chapter basically three types of farmers are described there in Kalpattu. The farmer first category that has been taken, landless farmer who was laborer, and the second it is taken the farmer who is holding the small land just 2 acres, and the third category that is taken, the farmer who holds 20 acres of land. So let's see, Tulasi, she is landless laborer. The first example, the lady, she is just working on other's land and she is landless laborer, means she does not have her own land. Number two example, small landholder with 2 acres of land. The second example, here Sekar has been taken, who has just 2 acres of land. Third is Ramalingam, large landholder with 20 acres of land. The person who has 20 acres of land, this is given here, clear? So these three categories, those are described are in this chapter. Today we will be taking about Tulasi and Sekar and the problems of these small farmers, clear? And in tomorrow's chapter lecture, definitely we will be taking that different steps government also take to improve the condition of these small farmers, and we'll take the example of Ramalingam as well. Then after, we will be taking one more case study about one more village, that is Pudupet. Clear? So today what we are going to take from these, Tulasi and Sekar. Tulasi, she was landless laborer, as we already talked. She works on Ramalingam's field. Ramalingam, large landholder with 20 acres of land. And not only the land, he was having different factories also, that we will be discussing in next lecture. Next is, she gets less earnings as 40 rupees per day only. She just gets 40 rupees per day, and that is really very small amount. As a living, this is very small amount that she is getting, but she does not have any other option. Because these rich people, they have the different people with them as a worker. If they will disagree, they would disagree on this 40 rupees basis. So definitely Ramalingam or other rich farmers, they can hire any other laborer. So this there is no option in front of these landless laborers. They just have to do work on less earning, just rupees 40 per day. Next is, her husband Raman was also a laborer. Here, he sprays pesticides, he loads sand from river and stone from quarry. Quarry means mines, khadan. Okay, so here we are talking about the work done by Tulasi as well as her husband. Her husband also works there as a laborer, and he sprays pesticides there on the crops. Pesticides means to control the pest. Different pesticides they are given there in the crops. So he sprays pesticide. He loads sand from the river and stone from the quarries also. So this is the work done by her husband Raman. But we'll talk about one more thing. Just see, they are very poor. By the condition, we can see that they are just earning 40 rupees per day, Tulasi, and near about 60 and 40. And that work is not the work is also not they are having for the complete year. So that's why they are very poor. Now look at this picture. This picture shows the months of a year. But if you talk about agriculture, in agriculture there is no work in every month. Means some selected months are there where the people they get the work. So these are working months on agriculture. If you talk about paddy crop, so sampling is prepared there in the month of June and mid-July. Then transplantation, that is done in the July, August. September month, that is for weeding, September, October. And harvesting, that is done in November. So these are the months when they get work there on the agriculture. And other month, definitely they do not have any work. And in that case, obviously they have to do the another work to get their livings or to get their livelihood, isn't it? So that condition they are describing here, that the poor people, they are really do not have to do any other thing. They just dependent on the rich people there. And even one incident is also described here. Tulasi, she is describing that she does all the household works also. And they were having one cow, but they had to sell that cow when their daughter, she was ill. To save her life, they had to sell the cow even. So this was the condition of these poor people. This is the condition of these poor people. Clear? Now, the next is Sekar. Sekar is also a person who is having only 2 acres of land. Sekar has 2 acres of land. Her family does all the work on its own. He takes seeds and fertilizers as a loan from traders. Then he sells his crops to that trader only, because he has already taken the loan or the money from the trader. So whatever he has grown there in the field, he has to sell it to that trader only. Clear? Then he works in Ramalingam's rice mill also. When he does not have any work there on the land, in that condition to get the livelihood, because that 2 acres, that is very less land, and that is not sufficient for the family. So he has to work there on Ramalingam's rice mill also to get the livelihood. He keeps some parts of paddy for his family, and some part he sells to the trader. Okay. Now here, if we talk about Shekhar, if you see that, we have seen that her family does all the work on its own. Why it is written? Because the family that is not having any labor with them. All the family members, they just do the complete work, whether it is transplantation of the crop, weeding, harvesting. So all these work done there, the family members, they do themselves. They do not have any other labor. So that's why it is written, just her family does all the work on its own. Sometimes they just get help of the neighborhood, from their neighborhood, and they just give the help to them also. Means sharing of work. That can be done, but they do not have the laborers with them. So this is the condition of small farmers like Sekar. Clear? Next thing, problems of small farmers as Sekar, we talked about here. They have to sell the produce to money lender or trader at lower prices. We know that the farmers, when they grow crop, the remaining part of the crop, some part they keep with them for their complete year, and the remaining part they just sell it to the traders or the money lenders. Okay, but the condition of these small farmers, what is there? They have to sell their produce to that money lender from where they have already taken the loan. And that money lender obviously take that crop at the lower prices. So that problem they have. The remaining part of produce is not enough for the complete year. Whatever they have with them for the family, that is not enough for the complete year. They have to work as a laborer for the extra earning that we talked about. Sekar, who is working there in Ramalingam's rice mill. They also rear cattle for milk to be sold there in the market. And the another option, they just rear the cattle or the animals, those the milk they just sell it to the market. So this is the these are the problems that we talked about, the small farmers. The next thing, reasons for committing suicide for the farmers. Sometimes you might have heard the news on the TV and radio that the farmer, the particular farmer had committed suicide because the loan was there. So why, what is the reason for committing suicide for the small farmers? Now let's see. Farmers take loan from money lenders to purchase seeds and fertilizers. Okay, so in the starting, when they start growing the crop, they just take the loan because they do not have that much money to have the seeds, from to buy the seeds. So for that seed or fertilizer or pesticides, for all these things, they get the loan from the traders or the money lender. Sometimes seeds are bad and pests can damage the crop. And what happens? Sometimes we, when the seeds, they are not of good quality or pests that damage the crop, in that situation, they do not have anything, because whatever the loan they have taken, that had gone wasted. Okay? Next, sometimes bad monsoon also damage the crop. You might have seen sometimes the flood that comes or any other calamity that really destroy the crop. So sometimes the bad monsoon also destroy or the damage their crop. In that case, then farmers have to borrow more money from the for the daily need, because daily need that for eating, they obviously they need something. For wearing clothes, for leaving the house, that they need. So the farmers, they have to borrow more money for their daily need from the money lenders, and the extra burden they have in that case. Okay, so when they there is no way before the before these farmers to pay the loan, they become helpless and commit suicide. So this is the scenario, we can say. The situation in front of those farmers, when they become helpless, they are not able to repay the loan that they have taken. In that case, they really suffers a lot and frustrated, and in that case they commit suicide. So this is all about the problems of small farmers and the reasons for committing suicide that sometimes we hear the news about some of the farmers. So these are the some of topics that we have covered, and as I told you, in next lecture we will be taking the example, different examples how government is helping these poor farmers, the different steps we'll take. Then we'll take about Ramalingam, the third category, large land holder. Then we'll take one more case study about one more village here, and terrace farming. Clear? So in today's lecture, we have covered about the economic activities. We have done farm and non-farm activities. In farm activities, the in agriculture, what the farmers they do, we can include here transplantation of the crop or growing of the crop. Okay. Then next thing we can take it is weeding, harvesting, watering the plant. All these are the farm activities. Okay, and the non-farm activities, that whether it is making basket, utensil, bricks, or any shop is there, these all will come there in non-farm activity. Then we have taken different types of farmers there in Kalpattu. Sekar and Tulasi's example we have covered today. So I hope that all these topics, they are clear to you today. And we will be having one more lecture then with some other topics. Now, it's time for homework. Question number one. You have probably noticed that people in Kalpattu are engaged in variety of non-farm work. List five of these. Any five non-farm activities you have to write here. What are the problems of small farmers in rural areas? That the problems you will mention. Then why do farmers communities commit suicide? Okay, why do farming community or the why do farmers commit suicide? Here you will write. Then the fourth question, how much land does Sekar have? So these some questions you will be attempting there in your fair register. I hope that you have understood all the topics covered in today's lecture. So we will be meeting in further lecture. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.